Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are most welcome wherever you are. This is a special day and the Holy Spirit is with us and He's taking us through. And we believe that this is the day that He has made for me and you to rejoice and be glad. This is the momentum energizer. Today we had to have the classic hour, but to tell you the truth, I think God has made it in a way that we come and energize you. We come the momentum energizer to speak into your life. We believe that when we come, we do not leave you the same. When we come, the Holy Spirit comes to minister to you. We had to have that classic hour like today, but we had a challenge. You know, technical challenges, sometimes things don't work out. But at the end of the day, the Spirit of the Lord still dwells within us, and He has given us a new one that we have to bring to you. And we are here with a momentum energizer. Do not be discouraged. Don't say that they have come on Thursdays or Saturdays, not going to be there. My brother, my sister out there, Saturday we are also coming to you. But today we believe it's a special day and the special one that Jesus placed on the servants of God before us. We believe that He's changing our lives. Today is a new day. But as always, we will not forget the culture of this ministry and the Lord that always dwells within us. Before we do anything, we first surrender ourselves to God and we allow Him to come and lead us and take us through. We believe that He has all the solutions to all the problems. We believe that He has a word that He can send to us that can really build our hope, build us up to some level. I believe that it's only the Lord that can take us where we want to go. Not by strength, not by our mind, not because of our money, not because we're too great, not because we have a rich father, not because you're the president, you who is there, you're son of a president, not because you're son of a pastor. I want you to be the anointing of the pastor does not affect you at any moment. But the connection, the relationship that you have between you and your God really builds a lot. So we want to build on that relationship. We want to talk, we want to pray to God and tell Him that, Lord, we are here not because we are so good, not because we are so great, but You have given us an opportunity. We appreciate it. Just raise your voice wherever you are. You can choose to stand up. You can choose to walk around. You can choose to tell Him anything that you have on your mind. Just tell Him that, Father, I am here to receive from You. Father, I am here to receive from Your altar. Father, may You come and speak to me. Father, may You come and encourage me. Father, may You come. Send a word to me that is going to lift me from where I am and take me to another level, Father. May You come and bless me. May You come and increase me. May You come and minister to me. Just raise your voice wherever you are. Tell Jesus. Tell Him that, Lord, everything is Yours. I don't have anything of my own. My breath is Yours. My life is Yours. My heart is Yours. My body is Yours. I own nothing. For Scripture says that we are the temples of the Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit dwells in us, for it has been given by God. The time you receive Jesus, you receive the Holy Spirit, and He lives in you. Just surrender yourself to Him. Surrender everything that you have to Him. No matter the challenges, no matter the circumstances, I know things are not moving on well, but the Holy Spirit is here to change your life. The Holy Spirit is here to encourage you. The Holy Spirit is here to lift you up. I believe that by a word you can rise up from that sick bed. I believe that because of one word that is being spoken to you, you can rise up from that wheelchair that you're sitting in. I believe it's faith that lifts you up. When Jesus was speaking, He never prayed the born-again prayer that we usually make. He never made the Pentecostal prayer. But He told the blind man that receive your sight, and he received it. Maybe it's that word that is going to come into your mind, into your life, or it's going to come through your phone, and you rise up wherever you are. I believe that by a word, your life cannot remain the same. Just call upon Jesus, tell Him that, Father, come and dwell, Father, come and reign, Father, come and take charge, Father, come and own everything that we have, Father, come and speak to us, Father, come and minister to us, Father, come, send your Holy Spirit to come and dwell. The Holy Spirit can dwell in your home, the Holy Spirit can dwell wherever you are, the Holy Spirit reigns, and He makes the words that are coming from the lips of men, He makes them great, and He gives them the power to change and transform your life. I want to tell you that you do not need anything but the Holy Spirit to minister to you. He may not whisper to you in a very loud voice, He may not minister to you in a still voice, but by the one that cometh out of His servant, He can speak to you, and your life will not remain the same. In Jesus' mighty name, Father, we bless You, we exalt You, we glorify You, we magnify You. Thank You for this day that You have made. May You come and deliver, may You come and heal, may You come and change. May you come and transform our lives, Lord, O King of Glory. We do not have anything on our own. We do not have any money on our own. We don't have anything. These are days when we only want you, Lord, O King of Glory. Our money can't help us. Nothing can help us. But your word can lift us up. This Bible that was written years ago can change our lives. For it always has something new every day and every moment. In Jesus' mighty name, we worship you, we exalt you, we glorify you. We exalt you, Jesus. You are worthy, you are mighty. You can just clap for the Lord, for he is here to minister to you. He is here to change your life. In Jesus' mighty name. And I will come once again. If you've just come on our page, this is Revival Palace Center, and we are here with the Vital Energizer. I apologize once again. We're supposed to have the classic hour, but I believe Jesus has prepared in a way that we come to you twice this week, and the Holy Spirit is really going to minister to you. I believe your life is not going to remain the same. In Jesus' mighty name, for those of you that are just coming, this is Revival Palace. You can subscribe to our YouTube channel at Revival Palace Center. You can like our page at Revival Palace. And this is Palace TV. We are coming to you. Let me tell you, TV is coming to you. Those of you that want it on digital and you're tired of spending a lot of data, yeah, we are coming digital. And trust me, the Lord is going to bless you when you watch us. You can share this video. You can invite a friend. Give them a call that the Momentum Energizer is on. And Pastor Mukisa is here to speak into our lives. But before we do anything else, I want us to fast. And what you can do, I believe that the anointing that you honor worketh for you. Let's just rise up and just become the servant of God and just worship the Lord and thank him for the servant of God and his life. And I believe that when he comes to speak, he's coming to speak life in you, home, and in everything that you're doing. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Pastor, you're most welcome.
Amen. Pastor, thank you very much. Hallelujah. Hello, viewers, whoever are there watching us clearly from wherever you are sitting, and you might be just lying on your bed, we welcome you at Palace TV. It's already streamed on Revival Palace Center page. You can always go on Facebook and find us there. And if you missed some of these videos, you can already subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's Revival Palace Center. You will find these good videos that are going to change your lives forever in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
So as they have told you, I'm called Pastor Mukisa James, and I'm from a church called Revival Palace Center here in Nansana, Ghana. We thank you for always tuning in, always putting on your data, and you always make it a deal to watch at always every half past midday. You always come and watch, and I think you're always blessed in Jesus' mighty name. So before I go any further, I won't just fail to appreciate our God. We want to thank God for giving us this great opportunity. And we want to thank our lovely pastor, Pastor Maxim Wanyama, because if it wasn't for him, we wouldn't have been here on your screens when you're watching us live, wherever you are watching from, whether you're in Uganda, whether in Kenya, whether you're in Tanzania, whether you're in Dubai, whether you're in America or Australia, wherever you're watching us from, it is because of Pastor Maxim Wanyama and the trust he has in us. Amen. So that he can give us the platform to tell you the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want to thank God for him and the family. I want to bless the Lord for our beloved mama, Pastor Rebecca Wanyama.
Amen.
And our lovely sister, Precious Divine. May God bless you, Pastor. May God bless your family so much. Thank you for this grand opportunity that God has given us to share. And I want to thank people who are in the studio producing us live on your screens. May God bless you, sir. We have Brother Frank spearheading that department with the cameraman, Timothy Galwango. Thank you very much in just my name. So today, as they have told you, we always have the moment, the glass hour, but today, God has blessed us with the Momentum Energizer coming straight to you in just my name. So today we are going to share about, on Saturday we began on a topic called relationships. And as you know, relationships is a wide topic. So right about now we are going to dive in deep into a relationship with God. Hallelujah. You know, on Saturday we are dealing with a wide coverage of it. But today I'm trying to go deep into God, the relationship between you and God. Pastor was talking about it, and he was talking about our relationships with God. We have to take them on a personal level. So today I have come to dig deeper into the relationships, and today's theme we're going to talk about God still has a plan. God still has a plan. And it's all based on the relationship you have with Him. So we are going to look at this man of God called Gideon. The Bible calls him a mighty man of valor. Wow. I hope you and me, we discover that we are also mighty men of valor or mighty women of valor. Amen. Because the Bible says, whoever is born of God overcomes this world. Amen. Then I believe if you are born of God, you are a mighty man or a woman of valor. You're strong than what you even know. So today we've come to share about God's plan for our lives. Some of us always think that for God to have a plan with us, it's after we do good to Him. It's after we have worked so hard for it. Hey, I want to inform you today that it's not your hard work that makes God plan for you. Because the Bible tells us in the book of Jeremiah 1:5 that He knew us before what? Before we were even born. Can you imagine? Actually, before you were even put in your mother's womb, God still knew you. And the Bible says somewhere in Psalms, in the book of Psalms, that He knew the numbers of my days. Hallelujah. Amen. He knew the days that I was spent like on earth. He knew everything before I was even born. Because when we go back to Genesis, the Bible tells us that there were three, the book of Genesis, chapter 1, verse 6. The Bible says that they decided, let's make a man in our own image. So before even man knew that he was going to be made, these people, Jehovah Elohim, who's God in three, God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, they already had a plan for Adam. Before Adam was created, God had a plan for him. So I've come to you, my brother, my sister out there, that before you were born on this earth, before the face of earth saw you, God knew you. And you know what? He already prepared a plan for you. So I want you to not focus on what you're doing. I told you, I think there was a time I was saying, I told you, God hates sin, but He loves sinners. That's why Jesus wanted to say in a statement, and say, a doctor does not go for people who are healthy. A doctor runs for those who are ill. Those patients are the ones He came for. Hallelujah. Amen. So don't sit there and say, I'm too much of a sinner. I'm bad. I'm like, I don't even deserve God's mercy. I don't even deserve God to forgive me. Hallelujah. I'm speaking to people who are out there and you've lost hope. You've lost your way. You think there is no way you're going to make it out. Hello, I've come to inform you, God still has a plan for you. Let's see Gideon and the children of Israel. We're in the book of Judges, chapter number 6. We want to look at a couple of scriptures here. We are going to read a number of them, and afterwards we are going to share what the Lord has for you and for me. You know, we always tell you that the word of God is a double-edged sword. So as I'm preaching to you, it's also cutting me. It's also coming to me in Jesus' mighty name. It's also coming here in the studio.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Sure. So let's go to our Bible, the book of Judges, chapter number 6. We're going to see what happened. Did God in that time have a plan? If He really had a plan for those people in those days, He still has a plan for you too. The Bible tells us that He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. If He had a plan on this, on the generation of Gideon, in the times of Gideon, He has a plan in our times, in Jesus' mighty name. Let's see what happened. Pastor Henry, you're going to help me out. And we are going to read Judges 6, verse 1. We are going to read a couple of scriptures up to verse number 10. Please, follow clearly. If you have local Bibles, because if you are in Uganda, you might have Bibles that are in Luganda, that is in in Nyankole and all other languages, please follow together with us. Yes, in just my name. Pastor Henry, I beg you first tell them the version of the Bible you're using, because some people out there, they have different versions of Bibles. They might look in their Bible, what you're reading, they don't see.
Well, I'm so, reading the NIV.
Yeah, New International Version is what he's using.
Yes,
amen.
I'm reading the NIV.
Okay.
And in Judges chapter 6 and verses 1.
Hallelujah.
Verses 1 says, the Israelites did evil in the eyes of the Lord, and for 7 years he gave them out into the hands of the Midianites. Verses 2. Because the power of the Midian was the power of the Midian was so oppressive, the Israelites prepared shelters for themselves in the mountain caves and strongholds. Verses 3. Whenever the Israelites planted their crops, the Midianites and the Amalekites and other eastern people invaded the country. Verses 4. But they camped on the land and raided the crops and raided the crops all the way to Gaza and did not spare any living thing for Israel, neither sheep nor cattle nor donkey. In verses 5. They came up with their livestock and their tents like swarms of locusts. It was impossible to count them and their camels. They invaded the land and revenged it. They invaded the land, revenged it. That's in verse 6. Verse 6 says, Midian was so Midian was so oppressive, and the Israelites cried out to their Lord for help. And verse 7. When the Israelites cried out to their Lord because of Midian, he sent them a prophet who said, This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. I brought you out of Egypt, out of the land of slavery. I rescued you from the hand of the Egyptians, and I have delivered you from the hands of all your oppressors. I drove them out before you and gave you their land. And verses 10. I said to you, I am the Lord your God. Do not worship the gods of the Amorites, in whose land you live, but you have not listened to me. Verses 11.
You can stop there. Hallelujah. Yeah. Praise God. We've read a couple of scriptures here, and we are looking at Israel, the chosen of God, in times of the judges. You know, there are times when Israel was led by judges. There are times that Israel was led by kings. Hallelujah. And now we are looking at the times when it was led by judges. Right on that chapter number 6, if you go behind verse number 5, chapter number 5, we see that there was a judge called Prophet Deborah who was leading the children of Israel. Now, after the times had passed, something like 40 years, for the Bible says there was peace in the land for 40 years. So over 40 years, the children of Israel were well off, they were good, because whichever land they could attack, they could conquer because the Lord was with them.
Amen.
So now we come to a time when they think they're now familiar. Do you know, God, this is where we get trouble. Oh, I always hear people say, when we had just gotten saved, we had the fire. We are preaching the gospel like never.
Amen.
Have you ever had people say such things? We used to do evangelism. We used to do this and this. The problem is some of them are our elders. You can't confront them and say, what happened? But really, in your heart, you can ask yourself, then what happened?
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Mm.
So, there is this, what we call, people get familiar. The pastor always says a word that anointing you don't honor won't work for you.
Mm.
Now, we have a problem that some of the people we are familiar to the anointing of God, we are familiar with the hand of God, that we tend to do our own things. We tend to forget who helped us to reach where we are.
Amen.
Some of us, if I'm not mistaken, most of us, we focus on where we want to go. We always take no thought of thinking about where we've come from.
Amen.
You know, where you've come from gives you the strength to proceed to where you're going. Now, when you don't honor where God has brought you out from, you won't be the strength to proceed.
Amen.
That was the problem of the children of Israel. They were brought out of Egypt. When they reached the desert, they told Aaron, you know what? We are not going to wait for Moses. The God is bringing, we know not about. So, please, just save us time. Just make for us a golden calf. That's what they did. The problem was they forgot where God had brought them from. So, when you look at the Bible, God tells us about what Israel did before God. It was evil. Now, most of the people, according to apparent situation of COVID-19, people are relating it with the wrath of God. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, the wrath of God is not only on a particular issue. It's made out of a mass of things that we do before Him.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You know, some of the people have been doing homosexuality, and now they think God is annoyed because of COVID? Come on! God is not annoyed because of the small COVID. God is annoyed about all the behaviors that we have been behaving before Him.
Amen.
Some of us, we see that we are equal to Him.
Sure.
That's why the Bible says, some people think they are equal to God, but there are times He shows that He's more than them.
Indeed.
The Bible reminds us that in Isaiah 55, that the way God thinketh is not the way we do.
Mm-hmm.
And this is how he relates it. Do you see the distance between the earth and the skies?
Oh wow. I don't know whether people, there's a person who knows the right distance between the earth and the skies.
They have tried, but it's always, they say it's estimated.
Hallelujah.
You know what? Because they are not sure of the distance between the ground, earth, and the skies. So, the Bible says that's how His understanding is far away from ours.
Amen.
So right now people are saying it's because of COVID-19. God is annoyed. People get scriptures. You know, the Bible says you go in your houses, look there, because the Lord is annoyed, and wait for His wrath to pass. Hallelujah. Excuse me. The wrath of God is not going to pass until you work on your relationship with Him. There are people who are asking, where are Balokole? Where are the Balokole? Where are the Balokole? Ladies and gentlemen, out there, you are looking for the Balokole. The Balokole are looking for God. Because we know, no one can save us from this except Him alone.
Amen.
You know, the Bible says they did evil before God. And they were given into the hands of their enemies to torture them. They were suffering. They were in jeopardy. The Bible says they could plant their plantations, and these Midianites, you know, the Bible says God gave Israel in the hands of Midianites for 7 years. But did you see, as we are reading here, when they used to plant their crops, it was not only Midianites who came to steal their crops. You see, the Bible has told us about the Amalekites. It has told us about the other Eastern people. Hallelujah.
So,
people, you don't have to focus on only COVID-19. You don't have to focus on only COVID-19. It's not the issue. It's the way we have been behaving without God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We've not been behaving in the way He wishes us to.
Amen.
People are tending to ignore homosexuality. People are tending to ignore, is it, how they call when a human gets to marry a dog? Gets to marry an animal. Is it bestiality? Something like that.
Bestiality.
Bestiality, thank you. We are trying to ignore all that. We are focusing on COVID-19. That's why you're not seeing Balokole. The Balokole are searching for God. Mm-hmm. They know it's God who has the answer. He's the one who's going to help us to forgive.
All those have been doing the rubbish in his sight. You remember when God was sending Jonah to Nineveh? He told them, go to Nineveh and declare to them that their sin has reached to me.
Amen.
Praise Jesus.
Amen.
It's not the sin of COVID-19. Because if I could check, you don't make a sin to get COVID-19. You just do care. You're just careless with your life if you don't try to wear a mask when you are in a place which is polluted. You have to make sure that you don't touch your eyes. You have to make sure that you wash your hands. I mean, that's not even before God if you go to the toilet and you don't wash your hands. The problem is with you and your health issue. It's your health issue. Now, there's something that we want to focus on that is bothering and that is making God angry. Homosexuality. You are a priest and you come and you put two people together in holy matrimony which of the same sex. Come on. Who do you think you're playing with? Praise God. Some of us, we tend to think we are equal to God. That's why some people were saying in Rome there was a man, a holy man of God. They said he's equal to God. That's why some Catholic priests were shared some powers to be able to forgive sins. That's blasphemy. But anyways, that's according to how they see things. But according to the Bible, if we have read the last word that God was telling these people, it was like, I brought you out of Egypt. See? I brought you here. Where you are, I want to remind you, where you are, you weren't the first person to be there. The Bible is telling us, isn't it? He has said in the verse number 9, the last part, that I drove them out before you and gave you the land. Praise God.
Amen.
Where you are, it wasn't you who was there before. There was someone who was in that place where God has blessed you. And he blessed you there because he loved you. Praise God. So, we don't have to pretend that we are equal to God who has given us the authority. You know, the reason why the devil, Lucifer, is suffering, given up to death, it's because he refused to know his limits. Praise the Lord. Because God dedicated some authority to him to be the leader of the worshippers. So he thought he could overthrow God. So the problem is, some of us on earth, we think we can overthrow God and we take his power.
In fact, for me, there's something I was reading in the night. In 1 Corinthians 6, chapter 6, verses 9. We can go there, and usually this is what we just say.
Yeah.
This is what people say. this is what they say.
Repeat for them the chapter.
1 Corinthians chapter 6 and verses 9.
1 Corinthians
chapter 6. This is what the Bible says.
Uh-huh.
Oh, do you know, do you not know that wrongdoers will not inherit the kingdom of God?
Wow. That's a question.
Do not be deceived.
Hallelujah.
Neither the sexually immoral, the idolaters, nor adulterists, no men who have sex with women,
hallelujah,
nor thieves, nor the greedy, nor the drunkards, nor the scandalers, nor the swindlers, will not inherit the kingdom of God. So this is what we are saying. This is the scripture that I want. So the scripture says that the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking. So people think that you will have God at any cost. Like you will, you know, as long as you confess Jesus, he will be with you. So you will just eat and drink and live life and undermine him and just be like, as long as you are Nikola, Nekumrundi kunonjakujam, Nekamrundi. Hey, my dear, the kingdom of God is not just eating and drinking. Let me look for that scripture as Pastor proceeds.
Amen. Thank you very much. The scripture we've read in the book of 1 Corinthians 6:9, check
if you are doing some of those things that are mentioned there, watch out. Men who sleep with men, hallelujah. Some people, you are focusing on COVID instead of focusing on the spirituality you people have been doing. Then you, some of the people are lesbians and they think it's okay. You know, it's like, I think there's someone who was like, you know, I think it's because men, I think men don't understand them. That's why they decide to be with their fellow women. Hey, that's wrong. God created a man and a woman with a purpose.
It's not wrong, it's evil.
It's evil. Praise God.
Yeah.
God brought us from afar not to despise him. Please, you don't have to cut the stem where you're seated. You don't have to cut the branch on which you're sitting on. You know? Some people think, since I have the axe, I can cut everything I see. You end up cutting the branch where you're sitting. What do you think will happen? You will fall down. So, instead of us thinking more of the future, brethren, let's focus on what God wants.
Amen.
I know all of us, we know we have things we wish for in life.
And this is what God is saying. I've got it. It is in Romans 14, verses 17.
Romans 14, 17.
Romans 14, 17. It says, for the kingdom of God is not a matter of eating and drinking, but righteousness, peace, and joy in our spirit. So sometimes people underlook the whole thing of righteousness. They do funny things thinking that they are having joy, but there is joy that is in the Holy Spirit. Not your own joy. You wake up and worship your thing. It is making you happy, but is it making the Holy Spirit happy? So we have to check and discern what pleases us. Does it also please the Lord? Are we just eating and drinking and just having fun the way we want and not following the Holy Spirit? You know, there is this, they say the kingdom of God is joy, peace, and then righteousness, but it's in the Holy Spirit.
Not in our own
understanding. This is why the children of Israel ran out of, they just lived life. They were like, it's okay. He saved us from Egyptians, he saved us from slavery, and he will still be with us. Let's just worship our gods. And in fact, the real reason why God is angry is because they worship the gods of They worship the gods of Baal, and they
gods of Baal.
The gods of Amorites.
Amorites?
Yes.
Baal? Yeah. All that stuff they were worshipping.
Yes, he says that do not worship the gods of Amorites. And he never listened. They worshipped it because it made them happy, and that's what is going on here. Made them have joy and they relaxed and had fun. Hallelujah.
Actually, the gods of the Amorites was Baal. Because Gideon asked these people, was like, if Baal was really a real god, he can defend himself when someone breaks down his altar. Because they had even built altars for the king, the gods of Amorites. They had built altars for Baal. Now, is this the problem we are facing here, brothers and sisters out there? If you're born again or you're not born again, the problem with God is not you being with a lot of money. The problem with God is not you being with a lot of children. The problem with God is not for you being prominent and famous. The problem with God is you worshipping other gods other than him.
Amen.
You do idolatry. You get some images like, this is my God. You get those, this is my God. That's the problem with God. That's why the Marokoli are not in public, because they know the one who says, we seek him in secret. We don't go everywhere saying that, now you come. We seek him in secret. That's why these lots of churches, at a certain point, according to the Bible, it commands us to gather.
Amen.
But the gathering did not stop fellowshipping with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We still fellowship with the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
As Pastor was saying, righteousness, peace, and joy, but in the Holy Ghost, that's what we always do. The Bible says, you go in secret and seek the Lord who was in secret.
Amen.
We are going to get an answer for the world because we are starting for a God who has answers. So, when Gideon, when the children of Israel saw all that,
What did they do? The Bible says they returned to God and they prayed unto him.
Amen.
When they prayed unto him, he responded. That's why I'm saying God still has a plan for you.
Amen.
No matter the circumstance right now, no matter the lack of portion, no matter the lack of food, Amen. No matter the lack of friends, right now, some of us, we had people, some of you had friends whom you could call and say, you know what, I think I'm down. Can you please help me with this? And they could help you out. But right now, they are also suffering with life.
Amen.
You know, they are also struggling to make it through. Lockdowns are like lockdowns. After the 14, the 21 days. After 21 days, it is the 14th. After the 14th, we are the 7. So after the 14th, this other 14th, I don't know how many we are going to be given.
And in fact, this is what I want to say. It's, you know, sometimes you sit down and meditate about the word of the Lord, and it says that I rescued you and I gave you the land, but I gave you this land. But what you did, I drove them like. What the Lord did, He says in the Bible that He'll give us the land, He'll give us the wealth of the evil.
Yeah.
Scripture says that.
Mm-hmm.
But this is what we do. We go into the land of the evil and want to live the lives the evil
wow.
The evil people live. And this is what
That's
He says.
Evil.
This is what He says.
Mm-hmm.
I rescued you from the Egyptians and I delivered you from the hands of all your oppressors. And I drove them out before you and gave you their land. So God has given you this land. And born again Christians are so, like, you know, we are all over the world. You Christians have made money. And I believe that it's not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit.
Yeah.
But when they get there, this is why we're having churches who are embracing homosexuality, you know? It's what I feel. Yes, God has given you the inheritance of the world.
Yes.
And you are having it because, you know, you have to have. God has given it to you,
yeah.
The wealth of the evil. God has given you the famous of the evil, the fame of the evil. But when you get it, do not try to live it. Live the godly life in the Holy Spirit.
Don't try to do how they want.
Don't try to do things the way they do it.
There's something I'm thinking about right now.
Mm-hmm.
I think some people think that in order to maintain what God has given us, we have to do as the people
as
to maintain it so that we can also maintain the world
on a lower level. Let's write it down.
Mm-hmm.
Before Facebook has been known as something where if you want to look for new pictures of the famous people, you have to go on Facebook because it's the first platform.
Mm-hmm.
It's the first platform.
Mm-hmm.
But this time, God has given us internet. God has given us Facebook. And we're using it for the good. Let me tell you, we have the capacity. Revival Bible Center has the capacity to get this platform and use it and call people to bring adverts.
Yes.
You know?
True.
And they put a cost on it, you know, for you to advertise on this platform, do this and this and do this. So, God has given us the inheritance of the world. But it's upon us to maintain it and push on to a certain level and say, yes, God has given this to us. People are using it to do different things, but can we use it to benefit the kingdom?
What I'm saying right now is like, people are letting this wealth to control them instead of them control.
Actually, the problem of the children of Israel was not because really they loved the gods of the Amorites, because he had not done anything for them, but they thought, since we are living in their land, I think let's also acknowledge their gods hopelessly.
That's evil
in a funny way. I call that evil. For me, I don't play with God these days.
We condone that.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. You can proceed, but I want to tell you, Christians, this is beyond the normal. You know, God has given us life, God has given us food, God has given us the wealth, God has given us very many things. But let's not try to live. You know, this is what they say. I find businessmen business people that are living in the world that are Christians, but are doing business in the other world. But this is what they say, that no, it's okay for you to raise the price of a shirt when this guy comes in and, you know, you uplift it because it's the law of business, not the law of the Holy Spirit. They say it is the law of business. You know, you raise it up and this one buys it on a fair price and the other one, you buy it on a fair price, on another price, and then the other one does this and then the other one does this. I don't know, why do we want to live the other life? You know, but locally they are doing a lot of cheating because, you know,
It's the world.
It's the world.
Hallelujah.
It's like getting a PA system. Someone gets a PA system, the speakers and everything, and they want to bring the world into church. So they say, you know, this PA system has been given to us to preach the gospel. But at the end of the day, they can hire this PA system to go and work in clubs and I found someone who was doing that, you know, right promotions of funny things, and I'm like, what? Yes, we've got the things of the world, but why are we trying to do things the way the world wants them to be?
Mm.
I mean, I don't know, this is a problem of the Israelites, and it's coming back to us.
Yeah, yeah.
Let's make this as a refresh.
That being said, Pastor, I want us to go to another level.
Amen.
Now, the another level I want us to go on is our theme of today.
Amen.
God still has a plan for you.
Amen.
Regardless of what you've done, you know, there are people in life who tend to say, I think I've sinned too much that I cannot be forgiven. Hey, you are still a child of God.
Yes, amen.
He created you. God loves you.
Amen.
There is something I tell people, and some people are surprising me. One time I was preaching it in church, and someone like, Pastor, are you serious? This is how it goes. The devil, Lucifer, is what I'm meaning. He's the son of God.
Amen.
And God answers his children. Mm. I always bring up this reference. Do you remember in Job chapter number 1, the Bible says, when the children of God went to gather, even the devil went.
Even the devil went.
Do you know why he went? Because he's not a child, he's a child.
Amen.
And amazingly, do you know what? When he reached before God, God was like, hey Lucifer, how are you? I'm good, Dad, I'm good, how are you? Have you seen my servant Job? Yeah, I've seen him. No, first of all, when they asked him, what were you doing? He was like, I was moving about the world. Yeah, they are. So, don't be sure that the devil does not reach where you are. He reaches everywhere, searching for people to mess up with.
And for me, when I was reading that, I was so shocked. I was like, these people get some time and they talk.
See?
And it's not only on Job that they converse, because there's also another occasion where these two people meet.
Mm.
And they, you know, they discuss. But oftentimes, you people don't know that, you know, you keep oppressing the devil. Devil go away. But it's just a matter of keeping the faith. Very many things will come to pass in this world.
Yeah.
Very many things will come in this world. But I want to tell you, it is upon us to keep the faith in our Lord Jesus and keep pushing.
Mm. Now, what I was trying to remember at, it was like, when the Lucifer went before God, he said to him, you know, you think this servant of yours loves you? Just give him to me. That is a prayer.
Mm-hmm.
He is requesting.
Amen.
And Bible readers out there want you to answer me. Did God give Job into the hands of Lucifer or not? Pastor, did God give Lucifer
the power over Job? He actually told him, you can try him.
Hallelujah.
And God looked. But there's also something that
Christians usually forget.
They usually read this Bible. You know, when you're reading Job, you can read it in a transnight, in a fortnight.
Of course.
But you don't know what it means. Here, when we talk about the usual life, you can't lose 10 children at once. Of course, you lose the first one, the second one, the third one. You know, the guy had over 10,000 cattle, the livestock. But it all went down. But it went down in a series of time. It didn't go down.
It was concurrent.
Yes, it took time. It took years for Job, because they said that for 7 days, his friends of Job watched him at a distance and they prayed to God, praying for Job.
Mm-hmm.
For 7 days. That means Job went through the pain. He was enduring the pain for 7 days, but went through the pain for some good time.
Yeah, yeah.
Does it mean that God was not there?
God was there. So what I'm trying to drive at is this, that you people have to know your position, God.
Amen.
The devil knows his position, and he goes and requests.
And they answer him.
Mm. So someone in church was like, Pastor, are you serious? He said, yes, don't you read the Bible? God said to the devil, God said to the devil, there you go.
God answered the prayer of the devil.
Of the devil. Indeed.
Come on. Lucifer, we see him as the devil because he did evil in God's sight and he's planning to take us away from him. That's why he's so bad. But there is a reason why he's not yet dead. Praise Jesus.
Amen.
He's not dead because he wants you and me to be tested in this world so that you can approve to be worthy. And good enough, you don't have to use your own strength. This is why the Holy Spirit is here. This is why Jesus is here. He's our power. The Bible says in the book of Psalm chapter number 46 that he's my power. He's the ever-present in times of hope. When you need him, he's there. That's why we urge you, please, fall onto the feet of God, not onto any man, not onto the doctors, not onto any son of man, but alone unto God. So, going to another level, as we are saying, because our time is far running, we are going to a level where it says that God still has a plan for you. Regardless of what you're going through, my sister, my brother, God still has a plan for you. You've been sick for how many years? I don't even know. Because there's a man in the Bible who spent 38 years on the well, on the pool. He was sick 38 years. There is a woman in the Bible who spent 12 years with a bleeding. Hallelujah. So I don't know how long have you spent in your problem. But what I want to tell you is that God still has a plan for you. He promised and he will fulfill. The Bible says he's not a man to lie and he's not a son of man to regret.
Amen.
When he promises, he fulfills. So let's go to this other level where God encounters Gideon. The verse number 12. When the angel of the Lord appeared to Gideon, he said, "The Lord is with you, mighty man of valor." This is the trouble to all of us, all of you out there. It's not, we don't have to pretend that we are good so much. All of us, we have a human way we always behave until the other divine way comes in and changes us.
Amen.
You know, all of us are born again. The Bible says that we are saying on Saturday that God, Jesus sits in us, we are in him,
mm-hmm.
and he's and the Father also dwells in us.
Yes.
So the fact that the divine dwells in us,
Amen.
We also part human, part divine. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
That's why, as Pastor Jenner was telling us yesterday, that Elisha stood in the city center and told them, tomorrow about this time, there's going to be food everywhere,
Amen.
And it's going to be cheap. It wasn't because Elisha was told by anyone, but because Elisha was human and was part divine. So, because of that, we are always sometimes troubled whenever we are reminded that we are mighty men of valor. Listen to the response of Gideon. I know some of us, this is how we behave. This is how we respond. But please, respond in a better way this time. Pardon, the Bible says, "Pardon me, my Lord," Gideon replied. "But if the Lord is with us, why has all this happened to us?"
This is the question always asked.
Where are all these wonders that our ancestors told us about when they say, "Did not the Lord bring us from Egypt?"
Mm-hmm.
"But now the Lord has abandoned us and given us into the hand of Midian." 14. The Lord returned to him and said, "Go in the strength you have and save Israel out of Midian's hand. Am I not sending you?" Praise the Lord.
Amen, amen, amen.
We already stand to fight what we are.
If
you are not of the world.
True.
You are not of the world.
Amen.
The Bible tells us in Colossians chapter 3, the Bible says, we are not of the world. This world, we're just passing by. We are aliens on earth. We belong to heaven.
Amen.
So when Gideon got the confirmation of who he was and what he was, he denied. Hallelujah. Many of you are denying who you are in Christ Jesus. But I'm here to inform you and to encourage you. Embrace what you are. You have the power to overcome all the tests that come your way. The Bible tells us that he can never allow us to be tested above what we can handle.
Amen. Amen.
So whichever thing that is on your plate, whichever problem that is on your plate, God knows that you can handle it. And He knows you are a victim. But the problem is that according to the surrounding situations, we tend to refuse what we are. And the problem is, if you don't embrace what you are, you will never be this world.
Amen.
That's why we want to help you remind you that you have to always work on your relationship with God. But what's in the Koragana Katonda? Chikuletero kumanyani gwori. Chikunweza okumango soro kumikiza. It's just a storm. Who of you know that rain rains forever? It has a duration, it rains, then it stops. Praise the Lord. Hailstones, even though they come,
Amen.
It has to stop.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So even the situations that are surrounding you, they have an end.
Amen.
But how are you going to overcome? How Amen. Are you going to go through them when you are not hit?
It's knowing the relationship you have between you and your
God. Use that relationship. They told Nebuchadnezzar, you know what, sir? We trust you, you gave us authority that we live, we govern some states in your kingdom, but we are not going to bow down to your body posture. We are going to remain trusting God. Even if throw us in the furnace of fire, if He saves us, we well and good. If He doesn't save us,
it's all okay.
It's all okay.
Amen.
But the problem is, some of us we say, if He help us, we'll go on.
If He doesn't help us, we will look for our
own. We'll look
after all, we are living in a land where you can even worship the idol of the king.
And you
That's the way we are living, Christians.
So this is what you're trying to say, brothers and sisters out there. God has a plan for you. You don't have to make your own plans.
Amen.
You don't have to make your own plans.
Amen.
That's why I'm sticking on this so much. You are not seeing the Balokole everywhere. You are seeing the Balokole praying. You are seeing the Balokole. Some of them are out of lights because they know who saves. We are searching for God. Because the Bible says we are answers. Some of us, we don't know. Born again out there, you don't know your strength. This one Gideon never did.
Amen.
Gideon was strong. What does God tell him? Go in that strength. Did Gideon really have the strength in him?
He had the strength, but he had just recognized it.
That's powerful. Gideon had the strength. So all of these things. If Gideon knew before time, they wouldn't have suffered for 7 years. Is it right?
And in fact, the person who writes tells us that there were so many, like it was like a swarm of locusts and attacked. So they were like the good so scared. In fact, this Bible was written by someone. How could someone even wake up in the morning and write? Because they saw and they were scared and they nothing but the swarm of locusts.
They always ran to the caves to save their lives.
So all in all, we just want to tell you that God has a plan.
Hallelujah.
It's about you recognizing it.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And Pastor, you can go because the time is far gone.
So
I'll just close with the scripture.
Alright, so the problem is not the situation surrounding us.
Amen.
The problem is discovering who you are in
Amen.
God.
Amen.
And the mighty, the strength you have inside of you.
Amen.
Who is going to help you discover that? That's why David says, search me, O God. Search me, O God. You can't search yourself sometimes because of the situation.
Amen.
That's why Gideon was blindfolded by the Midianites.
Mm.
When he's told, he says, where are you? Where is the God asked about? So Gideon is focusing on the situation. He's not focusing on the relationship he has with God in order to discover the power he has to overcome. Hey, brothers and sisters, I want to tell you, God has a plan, still has a plan for you. It's about you to go to Him, work out your relationship with Him. He's going to help you to show you the way.
The Bible says he's the way, the truth, and life. I love you so much. I'm Pastor Kisa James. Pastor Henry.
Amen. Hallelujah. I just close with one scripture, and this goes out to those of you that have not accepted Jesus as your Lord and Savior. I want to tell you that Jesus is the truth, the way, and the light, and he offers all righteousness. I want to tell you that we do not make our own righteousness. We see very many things happening. We see a lot of things working out. But by the Spirit, we attain righteousness. But by faith, we attain righteousness. You might have done a lot of things against the Lord. But when you repent, you are given righteousness. Not because you are going to do very many good things. But by faith, you receive it. I want to tell you, very many things have gone out of hand. Sometimes you see yourself doing a lot of nonsensical things and all that. And you wake up in the morning and you're like, do I have the opportunity to speak to my Father? Do I still have, does God have any time for me to really listen to me? I want to tell you, God has time for you. But all he wants from you is to receive him by faith and receive his righteousness. When you open Romans 3 and verses 22. I'm just going to read very fast. Romans 3 verses 22. Verses 22 says that this righteousness is given to faith in Christ Jesus to all who believe.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. But there is no difference between the Jew and the Gentile. There is no difference between you who is out there and us that are this way. The difference is just you wake up in the morning and believing in the Lord Jesus Christ and you get the faith. No matter the circumstances, no matter what is going on, we receive the righteousness and we continue. And verses 23 says, For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of the Lord. And verses 24, and all are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that comes by Jesus Christ. I want to tell you, all of us have gone through all those challenges. We are not so righteous. We are not so holy. Some of you are saying that, I'm too bad that I do not have... I cannot be accepted in the kingdom of the Father. But all of us receive righteousness by faith. And we believe by the redemption that comes by grace through Christ Jesus. That's why we always exalt Christ Jesus. Someone was asking me that for you, you repeat God and you're exalting Christ Jesus. Because you can never offer me the sacrifice that Jesus offered me. Hallelujah. Yes, and the Bible says that Christ is in the Father, and the Father in me, and the Father in him, and him in me. That means that when I talk about Jesus, I'm talking about God the Father. Hallelujah. So I want to speak to you out there. If you've not received Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and your excuse is like, my sins are too many.
Too many.
I cannot be accepted in the Father's kingdom.
For all I've done, I've killed people, I've been a prostitute for times. I've been an adulterer. So a lot of excuses.
The Lord welcomes you. And I want to tell you, the world may not accept you. Mm-hmm. But when you receive his righteousness by faith and you stand by it, your life will not remain the same. Our time is far, it has gone. But I'm going to request Pastor Mokisa to pray for us and believe God. And I want you to believe God, you and me. I want us to believe God that all this is just to train us, to take us to the next step. But all that the Lord wants from us is for us to accept him is to accept him and look at the things that he has done before, and we do not look at the circumstances, we do not value, we do not wake up and make conclusions, government, if you don't help us, we go to a level where Moseba tells us if you don't go to a shrine, you will not eat. And people will do that. My brother, Jesus has the answer. Everything comes from him.
I just want you to take him and accept
him today, and your life will not remain the same. Amen. Pastor, you can
so take
this.
If you've never accepted Christ to be your personal Savior, I want you to repeat these words with me.
Amen.
Say, Oh Father, I thank you for loving me. Thank you for your Son, Jesus Christ, that you sent. I accept that he died for my sins. Father, erase my name from the book of the dead and write it in the book of living. I deny the devil with all his ways. I
believe with my heart and I confess with my mouth that I am born again. Hallelujah. So if it's your first time to repeat such a prayer, welcome to the family of our Lord Jesus Christ. The Bible says that whoever, in the book of John, the Gospel 1:12, that whoever embraced him was given the right. You have the full right to be called a son of God. So let me pray for you. Father, I pray for my dear sister, my lovely brother out there. They have given their lives to you, Lord. They have seen that you're the only way to change them, Lord Father. The world has denied them. The world has rejected them because they seem to be as too much of sinners on this earth. But the Bible tells us that whoever accepts Christ, that he was risen from the dead, and confess him, he is given eternal life. So, Father, I pray for them, Lord Father. Whatever ways they have been moving in, all the wicked ways of the devil, all the wills and plans of the devil upon their life, I cancel them in Jesus' mighty name. Father Christ, I sanctify them right away, Lord. May your Holy Spirit go and dwell within them, Lord Father. For the Bible says that in us, it's the temple of the Holy Spirit. So I request the Holy Spirit, go and meet them out there, wherever they are, whether they're in the continent of Africa, whether they're in the continent of Asia, whether they're in the continent of Europe, whether they're in the continent of North or South America, may you encounter with them, whether they're in the continent of Australia, Father, whether they're in Madagascar, Lord, I send your lovely hand to them, Lord Father. Show them your love and let them embrace you fully. Father Christ, I pray for your hand to always protect and love them and their families. In just my name. Thank you, Lord, for you. When you pray, you say, you believe that whatever we pray, it has been answered and we will be seeing it. In just my name. I pray that you've done it. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Thank you for watching. May God bless you and your lives. I believe your lives have been blessed and you surely have been blessed. I want you to just go on and share these videos. The Lord is going to bless you. And I tell you that when you share this video, you're preaching the gospel. You can also preach the gospel with your finances. You can send in any money that you want, even if you're in Uganda. Any money that you feel that has been, that is on your heart, you can send it in on the number that is rolling on your screen. And we are very sure that the word of God will be preached. When you do that, you're also preaching the gospel. You may not have the strength to make the noise as we do it here. You know, they call us, they say born again make a lot of noise. But I have to tell you, you may not have the capacity to do this, but you have the capacity to send in your money and you preach the gospel indirectly. May God bless you, and I believe you are going to be blessed and you will continue to be blessed when you continue to watch these videos and share them. You can like our page. And you can also subscribe to our YouTube channel. May God bless you. This is the Momentum Ender. We love you so much. Bye-bye.